Hi, welcome back to Coding at Home. Today I'm not really introducing a new game, but an unplugged coding activity called Follow the Music. This is an amusing activity that can be used to invent and build your own games. Let me start by coding the robot in order to make him follow a path. I use these cards, the CodyRoby cards, to provide instructions to the robot. I write here a piece of code, and then we will see where this code will bring our robot. So, you know that the green card means move forward. That's the effect. Move forward again. Turn right, move forward, turn right. Okay, let me bring our robot back because I will keep coding. So this is something that coders usually do. At some point during programming, they test their code to see what it is happening while executing it. And this helps them understand at which point in coding they are in order to keep coding and possibly fix their errors, the programming errors called bugs. So I obtained the effect that I wanted, so I keep coding without making any correction in the code that I already wrote. I need one more turn right at the end. Okay, here is the code. So, please consider that all these instructions have to be read in sequence. I put some of them on top and some on the bottom just to fit the screen. Okay, now let's see what happens when we execute the instructions. Move forward, turn right, move forward, turn right, move forward, turn right, move forward, turn right. Okay, so this sequence of instructions is bringing coding back to the starting point, but after having followed a squared path. Okay, so we made Roby draw a square on the chequered board. Okay. But my main purpose was not drawing a square, but was telling you a story. When I played this game in a school a few months ago, one of the kids in that school came out and said, "I noticed a rhythm." So what he noticed was that there were pieces of code, these three instructions, that repeated along the code four times. And then we decided to read them rhythmically, like forward, forward, right, forward, forward, right, forward, forward, right, forward, forward, right, in order to hear the rhythm that he noticed. And to make it even clearer, we decided to associate sounds to instructions. Instead of saying forward, we decided to say pa. And instead of saying right, we decided to say zoom. And it became pa pa zoom, pa pa zoom, pa pa zoom, pa pa zoom. And this sounds like a word. Okay. And instead of pronouncing sounds, we can even make sounds out of the objects that we have around. So for instance, move forward could be a tap on the table, and turn right, a clap of your hands. And this same code could sound like this. Okay. So this is exactly what I want to do today with you. But since we have not just two instructions in our instruction set, but three, I get rid of this code that I wrote just to introduce the idea of a rhythm and I will instead take the three instructions of our instruction set, which are move forward, turn left, and turn right. Here they are. And we need to associate different sounds to each of them. So what I want to do right now with you is to use sounds instead of cards to encode the instructions in our instruction set. There are many different ways of making three different sounds. So you can sing something different. You can make sounds with your voice, or you can tap different objects around you, and so on. But if you want to make them even more distinguishable from each other, the sounds, I mean, you can even use notes. And I have three glasses with different amounts of water. As you know, if you take a glass and you hit it, it makes a sound. But the sound depends on the amount of water in it. Different sound. And this is yet another sound. Okay? So let me prevent them from touching. Okay? Three different sounds. So using these sounds, I can try to write a program. Okay, let's see if it works. So this is move forward, this is turn left, this is turn right. Okay, now I play a short code and you have to try to figure out which instructions I'm encoding and to find the final destination of our robot. Okay, let's try. You can even try to follow the little spoon to see which glass I'm hitting. Okay, those were not the instructions that I meant to provide to the robot. The ones that I am playing right now are the instructions that you have to understand. Okay, once more. Okay, so forward, right, forward, forward, left, forward, right, forward, forward, left. Okay, you see, it sounds like a music. And if you find the proper amount to make the glasses sound like the notes, you can even try to play a little song. There are only three notes in this case, but you know, with three notes you can make many different songs, and there are very famous songs that are just composed out of three notes. Okay, now let me bring Roby back, and well, to bring him back I can try to program it using our sounds. Turn left, move forward twice, turn left, move forward, and turn left. Turn left, move forward twice, turn left, move forward, and turn left. Okay? Now, what about trying to follow the music without watching the litter spoon? So I invite you to close your eyes. I put Roby on this square here. The coordinates are C3, and Roby is facing it's facing west. Okay? Okay. So try to listen and close your eyes. Okay? Ready? Close your eyes. Okay, I'm repeating the sequence. You can decide whether to keep your eyes closed or to watch. Okay. Forward, left, left, forward, right, right. Oh, sorry. I did the opposite. Forward, left, left, forward, right, right. Okay? Forward, left, left, forward, right, right. Okay? So, as you see, Roby came back to the starting point after having moved one step forward. Because forward, left, left, forward, okay, left, left, forward, right, right. Okay, now, once more. Close your eyes. Forward, forward, left. Forward, forward, right. Look at Roby here. Okay, let me move the glasses on the top so that they are not hiding the chequered board. Okay, this is even better to see the little spoon hitting them. Now I'm making another program starting from let me start from here. Okay, this is the final program, and I challenge you to discover which square Roby will reach by executing the corresponding instructions. It's a very long sequence. Be careful. Try to follow the sounds and to listen very carefully to them. So this is thumb left. This is move forward. This is thumb right. Ready? Okay, let's go. Very difficult. I hope I didn't make any mistake, but it's very, very difficult to sound the instructions, to play the instruction instead of just putting them in sequence. Okay? I try once more. Okay? So I try to repeat the same sequence. Ready? I'm not. Okay. Hope it's correct. And I'm sure that you will find the square reached by Roby. Okay, that's it for today. Enjoy. Bye bye.